Hello everyone, today we are going to solve problems with pulley systems. We are going to determine the acceleration of the four types of pulley systems that I introduced to you in my previous videos when I showed you how to draw the free body diagrams step by step. We start with the first one, the Atwood machine, with the two objects M1 and M2, M2 greater than M1, and here is the free body diagram that you already know how to do because I introduced that to you, as I said, in my previous YouTube videos. Making sure that the magnitude check is performed correctly, let's just very fast take a look if the magnitudes are the way they're supposed to be. Remember, there is only one string over here, so the tension, which is a pull on each of these two objects, should have the same magnitude here and there. And in this case, here we have 5 centimeters, here we also have 5, so that's correct. Then the forces on both M2 and M1 must be unbalanced because this whole system accelerates. So therefore, M2G here should be greater than T, and M2G is 7, 7 is greater than 5, so I'm good. T here should be greater than M1G, and M1G is only 3 when compared to 5, we are also good there. It's time to move on to putting together the equations. We are going to start, as always, with Newton's second law of motion, but we're going to have to write it once for M1 and once for M2. All these forces, though, all go vertical in one dimension, so this is only a one-dimensional situation, no x and y f nets. So for M1, we are going to have f net 1 equals M1a, and for M2, we are going to have f net 2 equals M2a. So now we are going to develop these equations, remembering that f net is in fact the vector sum of all the forces. On the first object over here, we have T being positive, and we have M1G being negative. So we have two forces, which added together should give me M1A. And those two forces are positive T and negative M1G. When we simplify this to get to the scalar equation, we end up having T minus M1G equals M1A, and that is for object M1. For object M2, we are going to have M2G in the positive direction and T in the negative direction, so we have a vector sum of two forces again being equal to M2A. Again, M2G is positive, so plus M2G. While T is negative, so this is a negative T. When we simplify this vector equation, we are going to end up having M2G minus T equals M2A. So now we have one equation and another equation. M1, M2, and G are given. We are looking to determine the acceleration. While in these two equations, we have two unknowns. We have the acceleration and we have the tension. So we have a system of two equations with two unknowns. What I'm going to do over here to solve the system, I'm going to add up the two equations, left-hand sides and right-hand sides, and that way tension will actually be eliminated and I'll be able to solve for A. So by adding the two equations, we're going to have T minus M1G plus M2G minus T equals M1A plus M2A. It is obvious that T and minus T cancel out. On this side, I'm going to factor out the G. I'm going to be left the positive M2 and the negative M1. And here, I'm going to factor out an A, which will leave me inside the parentheses with an M1 plus M2. And at this time, it's very simple to solve for A by simply dividing both sides by M1 plus M2. So then A is going to be equal to G. Let me write it actually over here so we can see it better. So A is going to be equal to G fraction bar M2 minus M1 in the top, M1 plus M2 in the bottom circle. That is our answer. And that concludes the first problem with an Atwood machine. We determine the acceleration. Thank you.